Hi, boys and girls. We've been talking about our Stations of the Cross this week, haven't we? We're preparing for Easter by going through Lent and doing great things for Jesus. Since he sacrificed himself for us, we're doing small sacrifices for him to get ready for Easter, right? So we've been talking about our stations, and we've gone through 12 stations now, and there's 15, right? What comes after 12? 13, 14, 15. We only have a few more to go. Let's review the stations that we've talked about so far. The first station was when Jesus was sentenced to death. Do you remember what happens after that? What's the second station? Jesus takes up his cross. He's given his cross to carry. After they give Jesus the cross, what comes next? The third station is Jesus falls for the first time. You could tell by looking at the picture, right? After Jesus falls the first time, station number four is... That's right. Jesus meets his mother, Mary, along the way. And they give each other a hug. They must be feeling so much love for each other in that moment. After the fourth station, number five is... Right? Simon helps Jesus carry the cross. A man named Simon gave Jesus a helping hand. And I always like to remember this station for us to give others a helping hand, just like Simon. What comes after number five? Number six, that's right. And this picture reminds us that Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. There's a lady named Veronica that reaches out to help Jesus along the way. And as a gift to her, he leaves a picture of his face on her cloth. We're reminded to help people in need, aren't we, by looking at Veronica's kindness. So many lessons during Stations of the Cross story. Station number seven. Can you remember by looking at the picture? That's right. Jesus falls for the second time. You can tell how weak he's getting now in that picture. Station number eight. Take a look at the picture. Do you remember what happens? Jesus meets the weeping women. That's right. And do you remember what weeping means? That's right. The women were crying. But even though Jesus was suffering, he went over to the women to try to make them feel better. And so this station reminds us that if we see someone that needs our help, we help them, we show them kindness. Even though we might be sad, we try to help others, just like Jesus. After the eighth station is the ninth station. Can you remember what happened in station number nine? That's right, boys and girls. Jesus falls for the third time. And Jesus looks completely exhausted, doesn't he? Like he can't go any further. But yet he does. He doesn't give up. He knows that this is his greatest sacrifice for all of us. And when we think of giving up sometimes when things get difficult, we just remember this station of the cross and we say, don't give up. If Jesus could do it, we can do it too, right? Station number 10. Do Do you remember, boys and girls? Jesus is stripped of his clothing. And we remember how sad that must have felt for him. And we think to ourselves how much we want to share with others that don't have food and clothes. After station number 10 is station number 11. We talked about this station yesterday. Jesus was nailed to the cross. And we remember that Jesus suffered so much. And we remember sometimes when we get bored at home and we feel that we can't go out, we remember how much Jesus suffered for us. And we sacrifice that, don't we? And we say, we offer it up to Jesus. After the 11th station is station number 12. And station number 12 is when Jesus dies on the cross. And we can see his mother Mary and his apostle friend named John and some other disciples. And they were with Jesus at that moment. And remember what we said yesterday? Even when Jesus was taking his last breath, he asked God his Father to forgive the people who hurt him. So this station reminds us, boys and girls, to forgive others. To say, I'm sorry if we hurt someone. And to forgive others when they say, I'm sorry to us. I think we're ready to go on with our story. Let's take a look at station number 13. Jesus is taken down from the cross. And so a few hours had gone by, and poor Jesus, his suffering was over. He died on the cross, and now he was laid into his mother's arms, and Mother Mary had Jesus in her arms. And I'm sure that was a very sad moment for her as a mother, her only son. And his friends were there to comfort Mary. And they decided, let's get Jesus ready to bury now. Let's take a look inside our station number 13 egg. Here's our wooden heart with our cross on it for Jesus. And it says, Jesus is taken down from the cross. And what better place to go than into the arms of his mother, Mary. And here's a picture of Mary with Jesus in her arms. The most loving place Jesus could have gone was into the arms of his dear mother Mary. And this station reminds us, if we see someone hurting, to give them a great big hug. And we promise Jesus that we'll do all of the things that he taught us while he was on earth. We'll be his arms that give to the poor, and will be his feet to visit the sick, and will be his heart to love all of those around us. We have one more station for today. Station number 14. After Jesus was taken down from the cross, his friends and Mother Mary placed him in a tomb. This was like a big carved out rocky area. You can see in the picture the crosses in the background. They found this empty tomb. It was one of Jesus's friends. And his friend said, you can use my tomb to put Jesus's body. So they wrapped Jesus up in some new cloths and they laid him in the tomb. And then they rolled a big rock in front of the tomb. Let's take a look inside our station number 14 egg. Here's our wooden hearts with our cross sticker. And it says, Jesus is laid in the tomb. And inside our egg is a stone. It's a rock to remind us that there was a rock, a big rock, that was rolled across the entrance of the tomb. And we say, Jesus, we praise you. Jesus, we thank you. Jesus, we love you. Amen. I have a song for you. It's kind of like the song we did yesterday, Were You There? One of my favorites for Stations of the Cross. Our story doesn't end there, boys and girls. We have one more station tomorrow. And you know which egg it is. It's our 15th egg. And remember, it's not purple, it's white. And there is a happy ending to this story. And we'll find out what it is tomorrow. I'll see you soon.